Whatever Riddler's built beneath Chinatown, it's not going to stop me.
Isn't it? The opportunity to even glimpse my greatness, the dawning realization of just how insignificant, how unworthy of note you really are? These trials are my masterpieces, Detective. When I have defeated you, they will become monuments to my genius, testaments to your stupidity. Crowds of school children will pack themselves in this elevator, eager to see for themselves the place where the Dark Knight was defeated. They won't understand a thing, of course, but they'll come. That even you should manage a feeble grasp of the premise. You must provide power to this board, Detective. You know, Dark Knight, on balance, I don't think you're going to figure this out. Batman, keep rubbing those two brain cells together and you just might produce a spark. This isn't just a test of intelligence, Dark Knight. It's a test of skill. I'm in need of a more worthy nemesis. Nemesis. Well done, detective. Your true calling as a third-rate circus stuntman becomes clearer by the day. Congratulations, Dark Knight. You've earned the right to play the next part of the puzzle. Head over to the board.
Oh, joy. Time to play the Will My Head Explode game again.
Good luck, Catwoman. Good luck. Given Batman's limited intelligence, I'm afraid you're going to need it. I used to dream of Batman's death, I admit.
You'd better be right, Batman. Head still attached? Great. Collar still attached? Not so great.
Congratulations! You've achieved a very minor victory of not being as stupid as you look. Now, Catwoman, celebrate your survival by telling Batman all about the exciting orphanage development.
No, you do it.
Now, Kitty.
Why, Batman, there's a big mysterious green door.
Yes, there is. Come back to the orphanage, Batman, and I'll let the pair of you through it. You should, I hope, be beginning to comprehend the breadth of the tasks ahead of you, the sheer scale of the gauntlet I have thrown down. Or perhaps not. Perhaps you're feeling cocky. Perhaps these early victories have filled you with early false hope. Well then, ride that wave of smug satisfaction all the way back to the orphanage. I'm waiting.
Orphanage.
Bathroom.
I need to stay within range of the remote control.
Let's talk about Riddler.
I'll tell you everything!
Thank you. Alfred, I found a fourth victim.
Highly regrettable, Master Bruce. All we can do is hope this body yields some clues as to the killer's identity.
I've seen that pattern of scar tissue before. It's a bite mark. Analyzing its radius points to a species of Selachomorpha. This particular variety of shark is only found in the waters off the coast of North Gotham. The victim is fitted with an ocular prosthesis. This specific type of medical-grade acrylic was used only once during a trial 5 years ago. Signs of trauma to the upper arm. At some point, titanium screws have been implanted to repair a fractured humerus. Alfred, the victim's name is Lisa Mendez.
She had quite a troubled upbringing, sir. Orphaned age 9, foster homes, drug abuse. She developed a talent for surfing, hence the shark attack. Tragically, it's also how she lost her boyfriend. She was working for a Christian charity in Tucson, Arizona, when she went missing.
Have you found anything linking the victims?
I can find no personal or professional links between the victims, but they each went missing near state parks or playing fields.
Try and find anything connecting those places.
Of course, sir. I'll look into it.
Thank you.
Riddler, talk while you still can.
I'll tell you everything I know!
It'll do.
So what, we gotta listen to Scarecrow lecture us all night?
From a previous life. Why hold with a hand when a hook will suffice?
Find something soon. I'm punching you in the face. Man, there are tanks everywhere. Big ones, small ones. I wouldn't be surprised if some of them started flying. People. No way we're giving it back. Evacuate? Screw that. Scarecrow don't scare me. Ugh!
I don't know what to say. I didn't think anyone was coming. I've had a bad feeling about this city for weeks. Ever since the fire started.
I need more evidence to be certain. But I think your crew was tackling the work of one serial arsonist.
Great! Guess it wouldn't be Gotham without a crazy pyro running loose, huh? You know, the chief always said we'd get through it. But I don't know anymore. Not after this.
Everything's going to be okay. You'll be safe with the rest of your men back at GCPD.
I used to kid myself the good people in this city outweighed the bad. Not anymore.
Make me crack your skull and look for the answers inside.
Now talk!
The right choice.
Back up! It's the bat! Drive! Drive!